Here is the Copia-TH series box. Unpack the box and check the accessories. Use wire stripper to strip the negative wire insulation layer to a suitable length. Insert the wire into the negative terminal. Insert the terminal into the negative PV connector and lock the nut. Use wire stripper to strip the positive wire insulation layer to a suitable length. Insert the wire into the terminal. Insert the terminal into the positive PV connector and lock the nut. Strip the positive wire insulation layer to a suitable length. Insert the positive wire into the positive terminal. Insert the positive terminal into the positive battery connector and lock the nut. Strip the negative wire insulation layer to a suitable length. Insert negative wire into the negative terminal. Insert the negative terminal into the negative battery connector and lock the nut. Disassemble the plug connector and unscrew the terminals. Check the terminal. 7485B and 8485A are for meter communication port. Left side port is for BMS communication port, and right side port is for meter port. It can also communicate with meter. Use blue cable as 485B, brown cable as 485A. Strip the wire insulation layer to a suitable length. Insert the cable into the corresponding terminal. Use slotted screwdriver to loose 7 and 8 connector. Insert the cable into the corresponding connector. Tighten the connector 7 and 8 screws and confirm all connected well. Insert BMS communication cable into the terminal. Use network pliers and follow the inverter user manual to make RJ45 terminal. Use network pliers to crimp the RJ45 connector. Check whether the cable color sequence is correct. Insert BMS RJ45 terminal into BMS port. Attach the plug connector to the main body and plug it into the empty hole. Then tighten them. Strip the wire insulation layer of HAC wire to a suitable length. Prepare to connect to the grid terminal. Insert L1 yellow wire into the contactor. Insert L1 yellow wire into L1 port. Use the hex key to crimp the inner wires and tighten them. Insert L2 green wire into L2 port. Use the hex key to crimp the inner wires and tighten them. Follow terminal port mark and connect them in order. And check the color sequence is correct. Insert the main cable body into the rubber insulator and tighten them. Strip the wire insulation layer of each grid wire to a suitable length. Prepare to connect the grid terminal. Insert L1 yellow wire into the contactor. Insert L1 yellow wire into L1 port. Use the hex key to crimp the inner wires and tighten them. Insert L2 green wire into L2 port. Use the hex key to crimp the inner wires and tighten them. Follow terminal port mark and connect them in order. And check the color sequence is correct. Fasten the mounting bracket to the wall. Hang the inverter on the mounting bracket. Tighten the safety screw. Unplug the PV and bat protectors and insert PV wires. Follow the port mark to plug battery and PV connectors in order. Unplug the grid and EPS protectors and insert AC wires and EPS wires and lock them. Insert the communication cable and you will hear a click if you finish the connection. Connect the ground wire and tighten them. When connecting these cables, please confirm all switches are off. Install the three-phase power meter. Connect the three-phase power cables to grid side in sequence. Follow the terminal port mark. Connect three-phase power cables, neutral cable and jumper cable in order and tighten them well. Connect meter communication cable on port 21 for 485A and 22 for 485B and tighten them well. Check the arrow inside the CT and install the CT sensor connected to port 56 on phase A. The CT arrow shall point to load's direction. And then install CT sensor connected to port 78 on phase B. Last, install CT sensor connected to port 910 on phase C. Before powering on, check that all wiring is done correctly. Power on the battery box. Turn on the PV breaker and PV switch on inverter. Turn on grid breaker, inverter grid breaker and load breakers. Turn on EPS breaker and EPS load breakers. Connect the Wi-Fi dongle. Scan a QR code. ECACTUS provides ECOS Hub for installers to finish the on-site commissioning. ECOS Hub is the new commission application for installers from ECACTUS. It is available on iOS App Store and Google Play Store. First, log on the ECOS Hub app. If you don't have an account, please do the registration using your email address. Select the correct data center. Then enter your account and password. Add a new site. The commissioning process consists of four steps. Only after transferring the site on owner's ECOS app account, the commissioning can be considered as completed. Step 1. Create a new site. Tap the plus icon to create a new site. Fill in all the information needed to complete the site details. When choosing the country or region, please make sure to choose the same country as the site owner. Otherwise, site transformation in step 4 will be failed. Also, owner's email address or cell phone is required. This information will be only used for after-sales service. Step 2. Add the device. Review this guidance and notes about the commissioning, as they can help you to finish the job more smoothly. Allow the access to the local network to add the device. The app needs local network and Bluetooth authorization, which is required for the commissioning process. Also note that only 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi is supported. The device does not support 5 GHz Wi-Fi at the moment. Input the target Wi-Fi account and password. Before tapping the confirm button, please check that the blue light in the Wi-Fi module blinks quickly. If there's no light blinks, remember to plug the Wi-Fi module and plug in after 10 seconds. Then tap the confirm button. The app will finish connecting the device process automatically. The app will need around 60 seconds to complete connection. Please wait patiently. Now you have successfully connected the device. Click OK to finish step 2. Step 3. Check preset configurations. Click on the Start Configuration button. Device will go through the checklist automatically. It will not take long if any of the configurations did not load successfully. Tap the refresh icon to reload. Make sure that the configuration meets the safety and requirements before saving it. Step 4. Transfer site. Double-check the site information field and make sure that all the information are correct. Also make sure that the host site is ready to be transferred to the owner. After this QR code is generated, you need owner's mobile phone and the ECOS app. Ask owner to download the ECOS app on his or her mobile phone and finish the registration. Make sure that correct country and region is selected. Log in the ECOS app using owner's account and password. Tap on the Add Now button to find the QR code scanning function. Scan the QR code from the ECOS Hub app and click Confirm to accept the site. Now the owner can see the real-time status of their inverter and battery system remotely. Once the site is transferred to the owner, the process as ECOS Hub will be finished automatically. And in home page, the site will be listed for 72 hours for installers to do the after-sales service. Congratulations on the successful installation of new ECACTUS site. In the installer's ECOS Hub account, the site will be listed for 72 hours. After 72 hours, the site will be removed from ECOS Hub and only accessible from owner's ECOS app. To regain operational permissions for the device, cooperation from the owner is required. Firstly, need the owner to obtain a device sharing QR code in the ECOS app and then send it to the installer through the methods such as screenshots. Secondly, the installer log the ECOS Hub app and scan the QR code shared by the owner. The device will be synchronized to the installer's ECOS Hub app automatically after installer scan the QR code. The validity period is also 72 hours. Installer and owner are able to see the device in their ECOS Hub app or ECOS app at the same time.